Papasa ka kaya sa research subject mo? Anong prediction mo dyan? Prediction, assumption, guess. Tara, pag-usapan natin ang hypothesis of the study. Sige, wag muna nating hulaan kung papasa ka o hindi sa research subject mo. Pag-usapan muna natin ang isang maliit pero mahalagang part ng research paper mo, ang hypothesis of the study. Okay, so wala nang paligoy-ligo, isimulan na agad natin. Ano ba itong hypothesis of the study at paano ba ito gagawin?
Hypothesis is a prediction of what your study will find. It is a tentative prediction about the relationship between two or more variables under study. It also translates the research question into a prediction of expected outcomes.
So let me stress that hypothesis of the study is a predicted answer to your research question. Also, it is an intelligent guess on the relationship between your variables.
Ka-schoolers, ka-researchers, nakita nyo yon? Ang hypothesis of the study ay connected sa iyong research question at sa variables ng iyong study.
Okay, so punta na tayo sa characteristics of a well-stated hypothesis of the study. Hypothesis ay, kapag ka isa lang, singular, hypothesis i kapag ka plural or more than one. Wow, English lesson.
Characteristics of a well-defined hypothesis. One, it states the expected relationship between variables. So, ito na yung pinaliwanag natin kanina, no? Second, it is testable in such a way that you can determine it to be true or false through your research study findings. And then, another one, it is derived from the problem statement. As we said, naka-align siya dapat sa research question mo. And then, of course, simple and concise lang siya. So, simple lang yan, brief or maigsi lang yan.
Now, question. Anong klaseng study ang gagawan ng hypothesis? Lahat ba ng research studies ay kailangang may hypothesis? Pero bago ko sagutin yan, baka hindi ka pa nakasubscribe, subscribe ka na. Tapos kapag may natutuhan ka sa video natin, hit mo na rin yung like button mamaya, okay? Okay, so ito yung sagot. Hypothesis is commonly used in experiment type of research, particularly in an experimental quantitative research.
So, ang hypothesis ay gagawin mo yan bago mo i-conduct ang experimental quantitative research study mo, kung saan nandiyan yung dalawang variables, yung IV or independent variable at DV or dependent variable mo. So, malalaman mo after ng experimentation kung yung intelligent guess mo sa dalawang variables mo na yan ay correct or not. Again, after the conduct of experimentation. O kaya naman, after mailapat yung tinatawag na intervention. Now, speaking of this, if the result of the experiment is the same as the hypothesis, then the hypothesis is accepted. On the other way around, rejected ang hypothesis kapag the result of the study is the exact opposite of the hypothesis.
At this point, alamin natin, paano ba gagawin ang hypothesis of the study? Well, of course, para magawa mo yan, alam mo muna dapat ano bang klaseng hypothesis ang gagawin mo o gagamitin mo dyan sa research study mo. So let's go! Let's enumerate the different types of hypothesis. At may bonus tayo, I will provide you with example under each type.
Kinds of hypothesis. First, we have simple hypothesis, a hypothesis formulated when predicting a relationship between an independent and a dependent variable. So our example, the stress level of fathers is related to the stress level of mothers. Next is complex hypothesis, a hypothesis formulated when predicting the relationship of two or more independent to two or more dependent variables. So our example for this one, The hours of reviewing and study preference has no relationship with student score in periodical exam. Another type is what we call directional hypothesis. This specifies not only the existence but also the expected direction of relationship between the independent and dependent variables. Now, we also have example for this one. It goes like this. The types of online advertisement positively affect the level of buying power of customers. Opposite to that one is the non-directional hypothesis. This one does not stipulate the direction of relationship between the independent and the dependent variables. Now, we also have example for this one. The number of hours in reviewing is associated with the level of performance in periodical exam. Now, of course, we also have null hypothesis, a hypothesis formulated for the purpose of statistical analysis. This one is always expressed as a negative statement. So, for our example, peer tutoring has no significant effect on students' reading fluency.
Ayan na, okay na yan. Maliwanag na yung mga different kinds of hypothesis. Now, among these, meron tayong two commonly used hypotheses, lalo na kapag ang pinag-uusapan ay experimental quantitative research study.
Gaya ng sabi natin kanina, null hypothesis is always expressed as a negative statement with the use of the word no or not. Also, it is generally denoted as H0. Alternative hypothesis naman is used in contrary or an alternate to null hypothesis. It is generally denoted as H1.
Now, let's take these two, itong null hypothesis at alternative hypothesis, in forming a concrete example.
So, let me emphasize that our hypothesis should be aligned with our research question. Now, in this particular example, ito yung ating research question. Is there a significant relationship between peer tutoring and students' level of reading fluency? Now, kung bubuin natin yung null hypothesis natin, it will be this way. There is no significant relationship between peer tutoring and students' level of reading fluency. On the other hand, kapag alternative hypothesis naman, it will be like this. There is a significant relationship between peer tutoring and students' level of reading fluency.
So ayan ka-schoolers, ganyan lang kasimple ang paggawa ng hypothesis of the study. By the way, meron tayong tinatawag na assumption of the study. Iba po yun na iba siya sa hypothesis of the study. Soon, gagawa tayo ng video on that. So there you have it, ka-schoolers. Nakatapos na naman tayo ng isang part ng ating research paper, ang hypothesis of the study. So let me just request you, no, to continue sharing our videos, continue promoting our channel. Marating nito yung iba pang student researchers para ma-assist din sila in our little way. Lagi kong sinasabi ay matulungan sila ng ating mga videos na ginagawa. Nakakatuwa, no, kasi merong nagko-comment na medyo na wala yung stress niya sa paggawa dahil sa panonood ng ating mga videos. Nakakatuwa naman yun. That is actually the purpose of our channel, no, maging stress-free yung paggawa nyo ng inyong research paper. Ayan, thank you so much for being with me until this part sa dulo ng ating video. Again, this is Ma'am Anna. Bye and see you again in our next video.